but one of the early books. There are two early books that I read while I went through school, which were in the field of science, and which I remember very clearly. One was called The Young Chemist, and this was a book by a man called Sherwood Taylor, and it gave wonderful recipes for how to do chemistry experiments. And I lost my copy of that, unfortunately. But I'd started doing chemistry at the age of 10. By this time, we had changed our houses and had moved into the house in the southern parts of Germiston. So that was 1937. Where there was a garage and which we didn't have a car. And that's when I started to do chemistry in a serious way. It was very difficult, of course, to get apparatus and this, but I saved my money and bought a test tube every 2 weeks or some reagent, and of course went to buy these at the pharmacist. And so those experiments there, which were involved, you know, in making pigments and so on. I started doing biochemistry shortly after that, which was extracting pigments from leaves and petals and so on. And actually discovering that anthocyanin pigments actually responded to pH. And needless to say, that was not an original discovery.